Last week's meditation was about full moon in Aquarius, the water element. Thrive, financial freedom, abundance. And I would like to follow up today with conscious financing, conscious investment, and our conscious relationship to our food that goes into our bodies and builds our health. So one of the conscious investments that I decided to make some 30 years ago, that I will spend money on organic food. And it is an investment. It is an investment because with each and every cent that I spend on organic food, I support organic farmers. I support Mother Earth. I support Thrive, the natural cycles of Mother Earth. And I also support my and my family's bodies with this investment. But that can be taken to a much further place. And if you are thriving financially and you are secure financially, where would you like to invest your money? Eating healthy in a very simple and basic way is not that hard. So although I have been a macrobiotic counselor for some time, I would not want to talk about macrobiotics, as it is just one of the many possibilities. But I would rather like to share some basics for eating clean. And as I mentioned, the first step would be buying organic. As often, as high in a percentage as you can. On the average, we eat about 10 kilos of chemicals through food every year. So just imagine a bucket full of artificial flavors, nitrates, artificial coloring, and that what an average person eats. And although these might have been justified by the food industry, their combination has never been tested. And they are just as dangerous as if you would be combining different medications unchecked. So, step number one, I would buy organic. This is a living earth. This is a living entity. And what people put in it, or left behind, I just found something. Need to be discarded, and that comes from an organic food store, by the way. Yeah, so whatever we put into Mother Earth, it stays there. There is no difference in poisoning the earth or poisoning ourselves. We are one bodied. The second one I would consider, the second step, that I would not support GMO seeds at all, at all. I feel it is completely violent, unnecessary manipulation energy. And there's a system that promotes GMO, saying that it is going to get rid of starvation and it will increase productivity and there will be enough food. So this is working with lack in the system, with fear, which is not true. Even in Africa, even in the poorest countries, 25% of the food is discarded. There is plenty in the system. Please do check this data. If I remember, I will link it. There is plenty of food available. There is no need for GMO. This energy stays in our bodies. GMO manipulation affects seeds outside, and I feel energetically it does affect our seeds on the inside. So that is step number two. And for step number three, I would drop sugar. I know we all love sugar, really. We crave sweets. We crave the sweetness of life. Please do try to find alternatives. I would rather make love as an alternative. Get a massage, whatever sweetness come out into a beautiful park. Try to get sweetness in another way into your life. The amount of sugar that we have been consuming increases every year. We are hooked on sugar. If you would like to read about it, don't believe me, read about it. A man wrote a book called Sugar Blues, and he talks about, he writes about William Duffy, I think his name, about the story of the sugar, how it, oh, look at that bird. No sugar for him. How it was connected to the slave trade. Africa, Central America, and then to Europe. It is as concentrated as heroin, and it does make you just as addicted. And if you don't believe me, try to be without it for a day or two, and let's see if people can talk to you, or you will be too upset. So sugar, if you cannot drop it completely, try to drop it gradually, have it only on a weekend, or try to find alternatives. So three steps, taking your freedom back, as these are all addictions. Junk food, GMO, and sugar. That will be the first three steps. These are not clean industries. They are not clean for Mother Earth. They are not clean for your body. So I would start with those three steps. I am finishing up this video clip from home, and I would like to invite you to connect to your conscious breath into your conscious bodies. This physical body is our home, our earth. We have been working with earth element today, nurturing our home inside and outside, treating it respectfully, lovingly, which is the only way to download earth information that comes through our channel. Only connection, only with connection, with loving connection, can we act and ground our intuition. Any system that uses fear, intimidation, anger, split, fragmentation is about cutting us from our bodies, from each other's, and from Mother Earth. So bring this loving, self-respecting breath home into your physical body, into your physical cells, Mother Earth, and breathe with her in oneness. We can use the inhalation for connection and the exhalation of letting go in a beautiful, balanced way. Consciously letting go of the old that does not resonate anymore with us, and creating space for the new earth frequencies with each and every breath. In August, we have the Lion's Gate open. There is this beautiful spiral of spiritual DNA of dolphin and whale energy. Playfulness, wisdom, creation, interconnectedness. Let go of the heaviness and the war energy from your system. Inhale self-love and nurture. Tend to your body so your soul can use it in a masterful way. Do not let yourself being pulled into victimhood, self-sabotage, slavery. Do not repeat any abusing cycles. Connect to yourself with the utmost respect and love. And that way we can connect to all others the same way. Thank you.